The easiest way to install Foundry VTT is on your local PC, but there is an annoying drawback. Your players must connect to it. This means you have to open ports everywhere, configure in the right way your firewall and the router as well. Even though you know how to do it, there are many things could go wrong and you can mess up the experience of your players quite often. Let me show you how to do that in the easiest way possible, even for a beginner, in three simple steps. First, open Foundry VTT and check the port in the configuration. By default, is 30,000. Launch your world, connect it with a game master. Second, click here to open a console and launch a port forwarding program called ngrok. Third, copy and paste the URL that you can see here and send out to your players. Of course, you can choose the HTTP and even the HTTPS. Just to check if the URL works, copy and paste in the new browser and have a look. It works perfectly. As you can see here, all the requests that ngrok is relying on your local server. How does ngrok port forwarding work? You download and run a program on the machine and provide it the port of the network services. In this case, it's Foundry VTT on port 30,000. It connects to the ngrok cloud services, which accepts traffic on the public address and relies that traffic through to the ngrok process running on your machine and then onto the local address you specified. I'm gonna show you how to configure everything you need. Open the ngrok website and create an account. There is a free plan that's good enough for our case. So you are going to sign up, but I've already done, so I just logged in. You have to click here to download ngrok software and you find ngrok.exe in the zip file. At this point, you can follow the instruction in the ngrok site. Open up the prompt console writing cmd. Copy and paste the command with your token ID that you can see here. I have hidden my for security reasons. Ngrok have created a file to save the token ID on your PC. Now you are ready to launch ngrok on HTTP protocol and 30,000 port. Writing ngrok HTTP port 3000. If you want to further optimize your time, as I did, I create a shortcut on my desktop. Go in the ngrok folder and drag with the right click the ngrok file on your desktop. Right click on shortcut just created and edit the destination, as you can see, adding the same command that you launched earlier.
Tips and Tricks.
In the tip and trick session, I would like to share with you a nice option to minimize the latency if you are in Europe and Asian region. As you can see, by default, the region is the United States. So when you launch ngrok, there is an option to set the region in your command line. So I'm going to shut down. I'm going to edit again the property of the shortcut, adding after HTTP space dash region equal EU. It means Europe. Launch ngrok again, we can see that the region has been changed.